Welcome to Balancing WIP or Work in Process. I'm going to go over the work in process financial statement design shown here, and I'm going to go over some best practices on tying out your costs, billings, and your over under, or billings in excess of costs and costs in excess of billings to your financial statements. So on this work in process report, we have your project, your contract with your owner, the price there, your estimate for your job, your cost estimate, what you've got for estimated gross profit, your current month billings, year-to-date billings, job-to-date billings, current month costs, year-to-date costs, job-to-date costs, your percent complete based on costs, so job-to-date versus total estimate, revenue earned based on percent complete, and your over-under calculation. Okay, which that is going to be your job to date billings minus your revenue earned. Okay, so to build this report in the financial report center area, got a report here called work in process. So this report is comprised of your project contract budget for the project contract column, your primary project estimate budget. This is a calculation column, so contract minus estimate. Got a percentage column here for gross profit. Your current month billings are going to be your actual billings based on the account group of where your billings hit and in which accounts. So certain accounts in your general ledger chart of accounts should be mapped to this account group. So you might use a more detailed account group called revenue construction billings and only map one or two accounts, for example, for all of your construction billings related to your jobs. This column here and your year to date and your job to date, these billings columns should be mapped to the account where your construction billings are getting coded to. So that account group should only house that construction billings general ledger account. Okay. So when you're doing account grouping, you might use something called revenue-construction billings. Okay. Instead of the high level revenue grouping here. Okay. So scrolling over, you've got your job-to-date costs. For example, your year-to-date and month-to-date, just different time frames. Same concept. You're only going to make and use the account group, only the accounts where your job costs are getting coded to through accounts payable or labor, for example. Only use the account group that houses those general ledger accounts where project costs get coded to. Okay, so over here, there's the project cost account group. Just make sure when you are mapping your accounts to account groups that they only house account numbers that have project costs hitting those accounts. Okay, so that these columns will appropriately show billings, costs, and not other things when you view this financial work in process report. Then we're going to come over here to percent complete. And that's a calculation dividing job to date costs, column 12, divided by column 3 over here for your total estimate. So how far am I done? About, I'm taking my costs divided by what I think I'm going to take to get done, the total estimate on the project. Okay. Then your gross profit, that's just a calculation column as well. Let's scroll over here. You've got revenue earned. So that's going to be your percent complete times your total contract price. So column 13, percent complete times your total contract price over here. Okay. Your over under is then going to be your billings minus your revenue earned. So job to date billings minus revenue earned. Okay, so column 9, scroll over. See job to date billings. And column 19 is revenue earned. Okay, so once you've got your billings and your costs all posted for the month and you're ready to analyze and create your WIP schedule, work in process schedule, and create your journal entry for the over under effect, then you run this report. You're going to tie this out to your accounts. So like we talked, these are certain account groups and certain accounts are in those. You're going to tie these out to your general ledger and to, or to your financial statements. Okay. So a lot of people will dump this to Excel and do a reconciliation, a simple one here. So all of this came out of Intacct, all of these columns right here. And we have a simple calculation here in columns O and P for billings in excess and costs in excess. So accounting standards requires us to put the billings in excess and costs in excess in separate assets and liabilities on the balance sheet, okay? And record the WIP entry as well separately on the income statement. So anything that's over billed is going to be billings in excess. Anything that is under billed is going to be costs in excess, okay? So these negatives are going to be unders and these positives are going to be over billings. So I'll show the effect in the tie out of the costs and revenue and where these are at on the balance sheet. Okay, so our current month billings and our year-to-date billings are going to be two numbers to tie out to the income statement. And remember, like I said, the billings here should be an account that you code billings to. So when we look at the P&L, using this one just for the billings side and the billings in the system. Okay, so the 10 million and the 44,303 right here tie out to my schedule. Okay, so I don't have any other entries hitting here. I don't have any other issues with my WIP schedule. Those tie out, that's a good first check. Make sure we've tied out the billings side. Costs. Okay. So scroll down here to the cost area. So I might have labor separate from materials, from other, from burden. So I might need to add up some numbers. Okay. My subcontracts. So adding up all these numbers here in this formula here, I get $19,557.85. Okay. Over here, year to date, adding these all up here, I get the 22.3 million for year to date. Okay. So I've tied out my numbers to my accounts where my costs and my billings hit. And now I'm going to talk about the over under billing calculation. Okay. So now on the balance sheet, I've got my costs and estimated earnings in excess of billings. And I've got my balance in my billings in excess of costs and estimated earnings. This is before the entry is made for the month. Okay. So right now, my balance is 25.9 million for billings in excess and 259,000 for costs in excess. So I need to make an entry to increase my liability to 35.4 million and to increase my costs in excess or my underbillings to 3.455 million. So here's the entry right here that I need to make to increase billings in excess and to increase costs in excess. So to detail the journal entry out a bit, here's, I'm going to debit my income statement account. It's in the revenue area, the 4,300. And I'm going to credit the liability account to increase my billings in excess. On the underbillings or my costs in excess, I'm going to debit the asset account and I'm going to credit the cost account change in costs and excess. Okay, so just to throw this up on the side here. So here's my $259,000 where I'm at currently and my costs and excess and where I need to be. So I'm going to debit $1,126 for $3.195 million. And then scrolling down for the billings and excess. You can see I'm currently at $25.9 million, but I need to be at $35. So I need to credit my 2035 liability account and debit my income statement account. Okay, so here's the income statement side. So I've got my $4,300, my change in billings in excess that I'll need to book an entry to, and my change in costs in excess that I'll need to book an entry to. Okay, so these numbers right here. Okay. So just to recap, you know, this comes out of Intacct and can be built in the financial reports area. You can then do your over-under calculations and tie out at the bottom here. Okay. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us, but that is the overview of balancing your work in process.